Alaikum, guys, it's Shafi.
Assalamu alaikum, Sali.
Alhamdulillah, we're here with episode 11, season 1.
Yeah. First thing, I'm sorry. We just want to apologize for not putting some episodes the past few days. We've been having some technical difficulties.
A couple issues here and there. But
yeah, we apologize for not fulfilling our promise by doing it every day. Sincere apologies, and inshallah, we'll try our best to make it as much as possible. And may Allah reward you for watching.
Alhamdulillah, we are here today, though. Episode 11, season 1. And today's topic is?
Backbiting. Why the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was talking to Abu Dhar and one time, and he said, oh, beware Abu Dhar, for backbiting is worse than zina. It's worse than sexual fornication before marriage. And he was like, he was surprised, the way you probably are right now. And he was like, why? And he said, because when a man fornicates, later on he repents to his Lord, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives him. But when you backbite, you really don't do that,
because
you don't really notice it. You know, so it's very, very dangerous. And you know what, you could start.
Yeah, we always like starting off with a little hadith or a Quran ayah, and today is some Quran. O you who believe, avoid much suspicion, for some suspicions are a sin. Do not spy on one another, nor backbite one another. Would one of you love to eat the flesh of his dead brother? Nay, you would abhor it. So similarly, avoid backbiting. And fear Allah, indeed Allah is most forgiving, most merciful. So, I mean, just based off these ayahs, guys, you know, Allah clearly states it to us. He clearly says, backbiting is a terrible sin. Yeah, comparing it to eating the flesh of your dead brother.
Yeah.
We would never think of this idea, this image in our head. Yet Allah clearly says it to us. I'm trying to think of the word here. You know, just the disgusting, the craziness of it, just thinking about it. SubhanAllah, it's just a terrible image. And that's what we do when we talk about somebody else behind their back.
Before I move on, I just want to make sure, if you females are watching any of this, don't, you know, I'm just saying what I know, I'm just spreading knowledge, you know, this is spread the knowledge, one. Don't get offended or anything else, but the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said one time, he said, oh, beware, he was talking to the women, for when he saw Jahannam, he saw that it was mostly full of women. It's mostly full of the Nisa. And people were wondering why and stuff like that. Before I move any further, know that there are more women than men in the Earth's population. So most likely, even if it's a 50-50, there will be more women. But another reason is because of backbiting. You know, backbiting is very, very big because people don't know what they do until they do it. They end up just talking behind their brothers or sisters' back. Backbiting is very bad for when you're fasting. You know, especially right now, it's Ramadan. You have a lot of time on your hands. You invited your girls over for iftar or your boys over for iftar, bring them over, and then you end up talking about people. It breaks your fast. It breaks your wudu. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also said that beware men, both men and women, for the number one thing that can bring you straight to Jahannam, if you cover these two things and take care of them really well, I'm sure that you won't go to Jahannam. And those things are, one is your tongue, and the second part is your private part. So, you know, take care of those real good, and inshallah, you won't have to bear the punishment of the hellfire.
And there's actually something small I want to tell you guys. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once asked his followers, do you know what backbiting is? They said, Allah and His Messenger know best. He continued, saying something about your brother. He said, backbiting is saying something about your brother that he dislikes. And one of the followers there, he was like, okay, but what if it's something true? Like, what if you say something, you're talking about somebody, but it's true?
Yeah, he said, Ali's ugly, and you know it's true.
No, that's not true at all. But like I was saying, if it's true, and the Prophet said, if it is true, it is backbiting. If it is false, you are slandering him. So not only is it a bad thing, even if it is true, if it's false, you're not only backbiting, you're going even beyond that.
Yeah. And you know, one thing, that one way that could prevent you from that, 100%. I mean, may Allah forgive us for our sins. We did everything openly, unknowingly and unknowingly, and the major and the minor, and the past and the present and the future. But if you see something going on, you know, there's a little circle, and everybody's being fake, or everybody's talking about somebody which you do not want to hear of yourself, just leave. That's what you gotta do. Something so simple, just
or,
walk away.
Or, before you leave, make sure you tell the people to stop, because it can only get you more hasanat if you're able to stop them.
Some people go on, you know yeah, that nigga, you know that boy Mustafa? No, he's doing things, you know? So, you know, I'm playing with you, he's right there. So, like I said, you see something like that, just walk away.
Thanks, guys, for watching. We really appreciate it. Keep tuning in. Watch
all the